I will praise Poles for deciding to put Fields in a situation he believes is best for the young man, who I think everyone can agree, whether you liked Justin here or not as the Bears quarterback, that you wish him success moving forward. But from what this means for the Bears, first of all, the drama's over. We finally know the Bears are taking a quarterback. I would say with 99% certainty, it's probably going to be Caleb Williams in April during that draft. They have built an infrastructure around Caleb that was not there when they took Mitch Trubisky in 2017 or really any other rookie quarterback, including Justin.
Definitely.
In 2021, adding Keenan Allen today, DJ Moore is there, a pretty good offensive line, the running game as well. Coaching, of course, is a question mark. And as far as the return, I know some head scratching around Chicago. Why only a sixth round pick? I think Exhibit A is the money. Fields was owed that fifth year option in about 2 months in early May for $22 million. The team would have to decide on that. The Bears, obviously, we're not going to pick that up. That is different from every other quarterback that we saw traded for more compensation. It's different than what Kenny Pickett was traded for from Pittsburgh because he was drafted the year later. So all that you got to take into account for what Ryan Poles was looking for to get out of this deal. That ultimately what he wanted didn't suffice, but he decided this is ultimately the best move he can make right now for the Bears franchise.
Yeah, and when we do finally hear from Ryan Poles, I'm curious to hear whether he would admit or whether it was a fact in his mind that these doors close so quickly. When he was just in the combine a few weeks ago talking about wanting to do right by Fields, well, in fact, he did that. But I would imagine, unless he heard word through the grapevine that the return wasn't going to be as great, you know, we kind of saw how the NFL felt about Justin, unfortunately. And it kind of hurt, too, that there wasn't, you know, a greater rush to get his services. As, you know, not only were starting quarterback positions filled quickly, but also some of those backup positions. So by the time, you know, the negotiating period started on Monday following Pittsburgh signing of Russell Wilson last Sunday, and then all these other positions were filled, you were wondering if there was ever going to be a destination. You knew that Ryan Poles would someday do it, but I was just surprised at the way the market shut so quickly. And, you know, there's even one team out there, Denver, that really doesn't even have a quote-unquote starter or potentially a backup quarterback other than, you know, Jared Stidham out there. It makes you wonder how Sean Payton feels about him. But great deal of admiration for Justin in the way he has handled this, and that sets the bar even higher. You know, you and I agree, and I think most people agree, those who wanted a competition between the two, it wasn't going to work in a locker room like that. It wasn't going to do either candidate any good. And if you were going to draft Caleb Williams, or whether it was Drake May or perhaps Jaden Daniels with that number one pick, it was going to put him behind the eight ball. And the Bears have had a history of not doing right by the quarterbacks in development. You mentioned the situations with Trubisky and later Justin Fields because he was not done right in his first 2 years here. Everyone has their own side of the argument as to whether it was the people, the coaching staff around him, the personnel that was around him. Now Caleb Williams will fall into a much better situation, but it is going to be on him, as Justin was a very popular figure in that Bears locker room, to win those guys over. We've seen some of the reactions on social media from the current Bears about the news today, some saying it's just a business, most of them saying that, but there were a couple that had a tinge of disappointment. I know they'll eventually get back in line with that, but if it is Caleb Williams or whomever, there's going to be a job there to win over that locker room, and is there going to be a job for this offensive coaching staff to do things right?
And I'll say this real quick, Chris. Again, going back to what the Bears have done in the past with the rookie quarterbacks, they brought in Mike Lennon to start as the bridge quarterback for Trubisky. That blew up in their faces. Trubisky had to probably start before they were ready. They had Andy Dalton here when Justin was a rookie. They wanted Andy to have the starting role. That only worked out for a couple games, and Justin was thrust in as well. They're putting all their eggs in the Caleb Williams basket to be great right away, or at least very good, because they're building a team they believe should be a playoff contender with that defense, the additions they made for 2024. You don't make those and expect Caleb to have some growing pains. He might, and he probably will as a rookie, but they probably expect a CJ Stroud-level quarterback from the get-go in what they're getting from Caleb Williams.